Wingapo, it's me, Chadu, in her junky car. Yes, for the time being, my car is okay. It's still junky, but it's okay. But anyways, this is a Whole Foods haul, and I have to do it in my car, people, because it's a lot of groceries. And if I were to do it in a sit down nice location, I would have to walk like 3 blocks, climb up all these stairs. So you have to work with me, okay? Well, you don't have to, you can click off of this video, like, I don't care, girl. But anyways, so I went to Whole Foods, and I only really meant to pick up some vegan pizzas for me and my boyfriend, but I was like, well, I'm here already, I might as well get some things that I don't usually get to get, because I'm not always in the area where there's Whole Foods. So that's my justification for spending as much as I spent. But anyways, so this is the vegan pizza. This is for my boyfriend. I ate the exact same one, but this one, it just has diet cheese, soy, riso, and portobello mushrooms. And then the guy was like, he just put it out, and he's like, oh, do you like parsley? I was like, yeah. And he's like, cool. And he put it on there. I was like, aw. But yeah, this is what it looks like. You can't really see, but hopefully my boyfriend likes it. I mean, we really shouldn't be eating it, because yesterday we basically had a feast of like vegan junk food. But for macrobiotics, it's like really is like worse, because vegans, they like, they're fine with eating all that extra stuff, most of them. But if you're macrobiotic, it's like vegan quesadillas, vegan cake, vegan ice cream, what did I, oh, vegan cherry pie, what else did we have? Vegan burger sliders. There was one more thing that we had. Oh, and cold soba, but it wasn't like traditional Japanese, it was all like fancy. So it was like, it was really like a junk food day for us. And then yesterday, I was like, we should just eat really, really like, you know, simple the next few days, since we ate like so much extreme stuff. Plus it was like really spicy. So, see, that's the difference. I should make a whole video, but there's the difference between vegans and macrobiotics. It's like vegans only think about, and I could be blanket statementing, but most vegans, they just care, oh, it doesn't have an animal product. That's it. There's like nothing beyond that. It's just like no animal product. But macrobiotics is like, okay, what energy is this gonna give me? Chaotic energy. Yin energy, weak energy, you know? So it's different. But anyways, not trying to bash vegans or anything, because like, I enjoy your junk food, vegans, but I'm just saying that's the difference. And there's many other differences, but that's a whole separate video. But anyways, then I got this kombu seaweed, because in a lot of dishes, you know, is we always put seaweed in macrobiotics, just because it's like a way to get more minerals into your food. Like when you cook rice, you put in a chunk of, and it's a whole thing. There's like certain seaweeds, because there's many different kinds of seaweeds. Seaweeds are sea vegetables. Just like there's many different land vegetables, there's many different sea vegetables. So kombu is one sea vegetable. There's wakame, there's arame, there's agar-agar, there's nori, there's a whole bunch of different ones. But, and each different kind is recommended to go with a certain kind of food. So I think it's kombu or wakame goes with rice or grain. And you cook it in there, and the sea salt that's on there, because it's literally from the sea, and whatever other minerals that are in the seaweed get into the rest of the food, so it's like better for you. So cool. Then I got corn thins. These are the multi-grain ones. I like these because I like the texture. It's like puffed. It says popped corn cakes. These are really good with nut butter, like any kind of nut butter that you like, and a little bit of even like fruit preserves or like natural jam or whatever. that's a good little snack. And then, ooh, this, people, this is so good. This is Manna Organics 100% sprouted whole grain unleavened manna bread. And this is a fruit and nut flavor. There's many different flavors. But basically, people, this is amazing. You need to get it. Okay, it's in the frozen section. And it tastes literally like cake. Like you're like, am I eating cake right now? But it's actually just because it has organic raisins, organic dates, organic almonds, cashews, hazelnuts, cinnamon, nutmeg. It's just so, so good. It's amazing. It's amazing. Get it, girl. I haven't tried the other flavors, but this one is like you literally think you're eating cake. But anyway, it's like all moist. Sorry for people who hate that word, but it's moist. Oh, and then this is spelt. Just because, again, macrobiotics, the central food group of a meal is grain. And as and it's a good idea to eat as many different grains as possible, you know, to get all the different, you know, nutrients, you know, different benefits from all the different kinds of grain. So, I never got spelt before, but it says right here, savor the whole grain goodness of spelt, an ancient relative of modern day wheat. Spelt has never been hybridized, so it has retained many of its original characteristics from antiquity, including complex flavor and whole grain nutrition. So basically, if you know anything about macrobiotics, it's about living in line with nature, as natural as you can possibly get, because that's the best to create the best health, the best condition, to create the best vibration, the energy that you put out, so that you can get the best vibration energy coming in. Yin and yang, cause and effect, karma, people, it's all the same. It's all the same shit, people. But anyways, so yeah, that's why I got this. But anyways, then these are organic dried shiitake mushrooms, because in a lot of the, you know, books that I read about macrobiotics, they have special remedy drinks, special remedy compresses for a variety of different little things, like, you know, even for bug bites. Like, I think in another video I showed you guys, I had bug bites. For bug bites, for like the kind of more minor health conditions, and even the most severe health conditions, there's you know, remedy drinks, remedy compresses made, and a lot of it is and a lot of the ingredients are like ginger, daikon, shiitake mushrooms. So I just thought it would be a good idea to just have these on hand for whenever I want to make, you know, some kind of remedy thing. And then, oh, people, okay, if you guys have been watching my Trader Joe's hauls for a while, you guys know I used to always get black garlic from Trader Joe's, but I think they stopped selling it because that's how Trader Joe's is. They get something really good and then all of a sudden they don't have it anymore, ever again. And it's like so great. But anyway, so I saw this black garlic at Whole Foods. So I was like, yay! So I got it. It's really good. It's like fermented garlic, and it's like more sweet. I described it before as like, you know how if you cook onions for a long time to get like caramelized? Well, it's like that, but like with garlic, girl. Girl! Girl. Try it, girl. Okay, then, ooh, I got some glass containers, because I also said in a different video that I'm trying to store my food in glass containers. Not only like my leftovers, but also just like my grains and my beans, because it's not a good idea to have your grains and your beans sitting around in a plastic bag, you know, sometimes for months at a time. So it's like, so I just, and I don't want to buy like a whole bunch of jars at once and a whole bunch of containers at once, because girl, I don't have that kind of money, girl. So I'm just getting like a few, you know, here and there, and slowly build up, you know, my collection. But yeah, I got this kind of medium-sized one. And then I also got Oh, they're in different bags, but I'll show you. But anyways, then I got the probiotic wild brine Brussels kraut. My favorite flavor of the wild brine kraut stuff is the smoky kale, but they were out of the smoky kale, so the Brussels one is like my next favorite one, but it's really good. You just need like a tiny bit, like a spoonful, a few spoonfuls, and it's like adds that little brininess, and then plus it's good for your digestion instead of taking, you know, those supplements that taste nasty and that are all powdery and who knows what's really in them. Just eat it. Just like eat it, girl. Like don't go on a juice cleanse, because then you're just gonna go back to the same shit you were eating before. Like what's the point? It's like so extreme. Just like eat the stuff that's gonna help you poop on a regular basis with your regular food. It's like, why wait until it gets... But that's a different kind of mentality, so if you want that mentality, it's fine, girl. It's up to you. It's up to you. You decide your fate. You decide everything. So, that's you, girl. You do you, girl. But anyways, then I got these butter beans just because they're a different kind of bean that I never see at the grocery store. Except for when I go to Whole Foods, so I just got it. I just mostly got stuff that I just don't usually get because I don't have access to it. So I just got these. They're a lighter bean, better for warm weather. They're more yin. And then the last thing in this bag is just an organic mini watermelon. Because they rarely sell organic mini watermelons at Trader Joe's. So I decided just to get this while I'm here, you know. Because I can't usually find it, girl. Anyways. Okay. Then, I put my stuff back in this bag. Oh. Cool. Then, I ripped the bag. That is so great. Okay. Daikon root. Look how long these daikon roots are. Yeah, these are amazing. Amazing. They're an Asian kind of radish. And these are organic too. And they're really good for helping you digest protein. Oh, look. And people, it's not even touching my face, but I feel the coolness. Vegetable quality, yin quality, cooling effect. This looks like a photo shoot thing. I should take a picture. But I need to have like a different outfit and I need to not be in my car. But yeah, these are really good for digesting protein. And this is a whole thing, people. This can help you with so many things. Like, you can eat it, you can put it in a compress, you can juice it, put it in a drink, and it helps you in so many different ways. But the most kind of common use for daikon is you cut it up and you lightly cook it, and you eat it when you eat protein, because it helps you digest the protein. And also, I forget which organ that it helps also, they call it tonify. It's like, it's a whole thing. But basically it helps with a certain organ. I don't want to say cleanse because I'm not sure if that's the right word. But it just helps a certain organ. I'm not sure. Liver, kidney, something like that. Okay, anyways. And then, and I got two. I know I'm not going to be able to go through one of these because they're like huge, and but I got one of them for my boyfriend, so. And then I got these Erewhon brand cornflakes, and these are so awesome. I never tried them before, but they only had two ingredients: organic milled corn and sea salt. Most plain organic kind of corn flakes that you find have at least a little bit of sugar in them. And you want to know why Erewhon doesn't? Because Erewhon is a macrobiotic brand. Okay, Michio Kushi, I've said this before many times, he was a very heavy cat, very influential, not only to macrobiotics, but to the overall health revolution that happened during the 60s and 70s. So any other guy or any kind of health movement that you're into, Michio Kushi had a hand in that, all of them. He was that heavy of a cat. So I'm just saying, what does that tell you about macrobiotics? But anyways, so he helped this brand Erewhon. He is actually a store, and they actually had multiple stores, but a few of them closed down. But the brand still sells the stuff to like Whole Foods and other kind of health food stores. But they do have, at least I know, one Erewhon store, but I just haven't been to it. But I want to go to it, but it's just really far from me. But anyways, yeah. So it doesn't have any sugar in it, because macrobiotics, stay away from sugar, because we know that it's fucked up and we know what it does to you. Read the book Sugar Blues. But anyways, then this brand Eden, Umeboshi plums, these are amazing. They're medicinal. They're just like, and they taste really good too. You don't want to just eat like an umeboshi plum. It's not the kind of thing where you just pick it up and you just eat it. It's like, no girl. Usually people eat umeboshi plums with brown rice. A kind of common macrobiotic thing to do with the umeboshi plums too is when you cook corn, like corn on the cob, you rub like a umeboshi plum on it. Is a very common thing. Also, oh my god, I didn't tell you guys this, but I'm part of a macrobiotic community, and you can probably find wherever you live, like just type in your city and then just write macrobiotic community, or like if you live in a small city, just like type in like the next biggest city next to you or whatever, and you can get together with people who are macrobiotic. But anyway, so I've made some more macrobiotic friends, and we have like potlucks and we get together, and it's really cool. But yeah, so at our last potluck, we had corn on the cob with umeboshi plums. Yeah, it was really cool. And we watched a Zatoichi movie, if you guys know who Zatoichi is. It's like a really cool blind samurai. We watched the first one that they made. Girl, it was made in the 60s. If you think about America in the 60s, they were not ready for that shit. It was like whole other thing. But anyways, I didn't even get to that. Okay, then this is the other jar that I got. It's a bigger one to store like grains and beans and stuff. And then I just got this. I was confused, but this was in one of the bulk bins, and it's hulless barley, which I've been on the mission to find hulled barley, because hulled barley has the outer layer of the grain still intact, because all I can find is pearled barley, and pearled barley has the outer layer removed. So when I saw this, it was right next to the pearled barley, and this one looked like it had its layer around it, but I was like, why does it say hulless? Because hulless means it's not, I don't understand. But basically, I'm trying to get the barley that's like the original barley that hasn't been processed. You feel me? Because basically, pearled barley is like white rice. It's like, it's not the full grain. It's like a processed grain. So it's not the best grain to be eating. The best grain to be eating has all of its layers still on it, so you can get the most nutrients, the most energy, the best nutrients for yourself. If you have one of the best layers removed, it's a lesser quality food. So cool. So I just got okay. But anyways, then okay, this I saw and I was kind of excited. It's another vegan kind of junk food thing. It's a vegan jerky. I never tried any kind of vegan jerky, and they had a few different flavors, but I just decided to try this one because it didn't have sugar, I just thought the flavor sounded appealing. It's just black pepper, so I'm excited to try this. Textured soy protein, that's what it is. I was like, what is even it? It's just soy protein. Speaking of organic corn, I just got 3 ears of organic corn because if you guys didn't know, there's certain foods that most farmers use a lot of pesticides and chemicals, and they're genetically, you know, modified organisms. So corn is like one of the worst ones. Corn, soybeans, all kinds of berries, zucchini. There's like, you know, so that's another thing, you know, in macrobiotics, you know, try to eat as much organic produce as you can, because again, organic means it hasn't been sprayed with stuff, it hasn't been genetically modified, it's as close to nature as possible, you know, living alongside nature is the best, is the shit. But anyway, so yeah, so I got 3 of them, and then this, okay, this is another kind of vegan junk food thing that I'm excited to try. It's this quinoa superfood raw cake coffee cream. Okay, I know this is not macrobiotics. All the people that maybe found this video because they're like, oh, she's macrobiotic. Yeah, girl, but I'm still transitioning, so don't get mad at me, okay? But anyways, this one has, what does it have? Raw cashews, filtered water, maple syrup, dates, macadamia nuts, cacao, coffee, chestnut flour, virgin olive oil, raw buckwheat, coconut, seaweed extract, coffee beans, maca. So it's like, you know, so it's kind of far out for a macrobiotic, but it's better than most things out there. So I just wanted to try it. I'm excited. Okay, that's everything from this bag. One more bag. Oh, this video is gonna cut me off. I just know it. Okay. Okay. Then I got 2 of these recycled facial tissues because, as you all know, I am a huge crybaby, and when I cry, which is often, not as often as it used to be, girl, but when I cry, it's like boogers, lots of tears, lots of spit. It's like, and when you cry and your nose is running, your tears are going, and you got all the spit and stuff, that's your body discharging, pushing out stuff that it doesn't need, okay? That's what your pimples are, that's what your poop is, that's what your pee is, that's what your period is, that's what your sweat is. That's what sneezes are. All that stuff is discharge. It's like stuff, your body doesn't need it, so it's pushing it out. So most of the time prior, every time I would cry, I would be like sucking my boogers and like swallow them. But now that I understand what my body is doing is eliminating stuff that I don't need, toxins, past toxins, you know, sugar, meat, dairy, medication, I was like pushing that all out. And so why am I gonna keep on swallowing it when the whole reason why I'm eating better is so that I could eliminate those toxins from affecting me now. So anyways, so if I ever happen to have a meltdown at my boyfriend's house, at home, the tissues that I've been using are like the just the regular like Kleenex brand, and they're like all like bleached, and they have something else, formaldehyde, in there. It's like, and I'm like using a lot of them all in my face, and then I start to notice that my face gets irritated and I get like dry. So it's like, girl. So I got some recycled Kleenex for me, and I got some for my boyfriend. So yeah, so I got another one. Then this is a fun little thing that I found. It's a tempura batter. So and some of the macrobiotic books, there's recipes, and they have tempura recipes. So I just thought, I mean, I didn't really look at them, but I just thought, oh, it's like the batter, just like, you know, ready to go. So this just has rice flour, tapioca starch, and brown rice breadcrumbs, and it says wheat free, gluten free. No sugar, no MSG, no sodium, no cholesterol. So, and it says non-GMO. So, yeah, so can't wait. Can't wait to make my own tempura! Okay, then, oh, this stuff you guys seen me show before, I think in a haul last year from Whole Foods, is like this pet stain and odor eliminator, because Minnie just pees in my room, and honestly, I mean, if I see her getting ready to do it, I'll be like, no, and I'll like put her outside, but like, I'm not, she's 11 years old, people. Like, I think she's past the point where she can be potty trained. I don't know. So if she, but she does pee in my room. If I'm not watching her, she'll pee in my room. So I need this. And it's like a natural kind of thing, so it's not that bad, but anyways, and then, okay, so then I got this Bentology stainless steel little thermos thing, and basically why I got this is because if I'm ever in a hurry and I didn't have time to prepare my grain before I leave the house, or I didn't have time to eat my grain before I leave the house, this is a good good thing to have. So you could just put your grain in here and put boiling water, close it up, and it cooks in the thermos. You know how I know that? Because someone who has been doing macrobiotics for 50 years grew up around the heaviest cats of macrobiotics. He told me that that's what he would have to do when he was on the road traveling, you know, for his job. And you think it's being hard right now, being vegan, being plant-based, being vegetarian? You think it's hard now, people? Right now is like paradise, okay? In the 60s, not only was there discrimination, you think you have discrimination now, girl, because you're a vegan, or because you're a vegetarian, or because you're a plant-based eater, or gluten-free, whatever your thing is. You think you have discrimination now, girl? Imagine in the 60s, there was nothing like that, okay? You were like really weird, like, because the people who were doing it were hippies, but not everyone, you know, who was into healthy eating were hippies, but it's like, it was very close, you know? And so my friend, he was telling me that's what he would have to do. You know, he would just buy like this giant bag of brown rice and his thermos, and be like boiling water, putting into his little thermos, and that's what he would eat, because there was no other options, no other healthier options for him. Everywhere he went, it was like processed sugar, refined, you know, starches, meat, lots of salt, rarely any vegetables. So, I mean, count your blessings, girl. You don't have it that hard right now. Yes, it's difficult, but it's a lot easier. At least now it's like a thing, you know? At least now there's like a thing when you say, oh, I'm vegan, you know, everyone knows what that is. At that time especially, it was like, What is that? That's so weird. At least everybody knows what veganism is. At least everybody knows, you know, vegetarianism. People still don't know macrobiotics, but that's because it's the shit. But anyways, okay. What's in here? Oh, then I got a glassware circular one, you know. You know. And then I got this organic sesame oil, because this is like the main oil that I use when I cook. And then I got ume plum vinegar. This is amazing. It's made from, you know, those plums I showed you earlier? It's the vinegar from that. What it takes to pickle those plums is like is made from that process. And it's really good. And you use it to salt your food, to give your food some flavor. It's kind of briny. It's kind of salty. I like it. I really like it. And then, oh, the last few things. Oh, okay, this girl I really need to put on right now. It's a 100% natural Thai deodorant. And it's like a rock crystal. Ugh. And I usually, the only natural deodorant that really works for me that I tried was a Sprouts brand, like sea salt one. And they have it in different forms. They have it in like a roller and a spray and a rock. But I think what it is the salt thing. That's what really eliminates my BO. And when you eat plant-based, you know, your BO is going to smell less. But, you know, I'm still eliminating those toxins, you feel me? So my BO is still going to smell for a while. But, yeah, and it doesn't even smell like anything. It's just like a solid rock thing. And I ran out of deodorant like a week ago. And so this whole week I've been feeling so bad for people that are around me because, like, I don't have deodorant. And I just smell like BO. And it's not that bad, but it's like, yeah, can't smell it anymore. So, cool. Yeah. But anyways, then the last few things that I got are just, some beans. This is the Amy's Organic Chili Beans, the medium heat ones. And then these are just the navy beans. They're yin, they're light, good for hot weather, plant protein. But anyways, that's everything I got from Whole Foods today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. See you guys in the next one. Later, haters.